الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إن الحمد لله نحمده تعالى وأستعين به وأستغفره وأستهديه، وأعوذ بالله العلي العظيم من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. Welcome dear brothers, dear sisters, asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept from all of us our good deeds inshallah. Ameen. While we are in the month of Rajab, and the month of Rajab is one of the four sacred months, and after the month of Rajab, Sha'ban is coming, and Sha'ban both and Rajab, Muslims, they have to prepare themselves for the month of Ramadan, and we have to receive mawasim al-ta'at, this kind of month, Rajab, Sha'ban, Ramadan, with too many things, and we have to prepare ourselves as Muslims for this special time during our year and in general during our life. Ramadan, Sha'ban, the 15th of the night of Sha'ban, and these days people are talking about al-Isra wal-Mi'raj, the two journeys of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, which is these days full of blessings. And we have to turn as Muslims our faces to Allah Azza wa Jal. And we have to repent. We have to come to Him. We have to get our nearness to Allah Azza wa Jal. And we have some keys for this kind of repentance or tawbah. They call it مفاتيح التوبة. And we have to receive these good days with first key, الاستغفار. الاستغفار, why not ذكر, why not صلاة, why not عمرة, why not, you can do all of these, but الاستغفار means asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for His forgiveness. It is the main one. Why? Because if we commit too many sin, and we've been sinning, and we're still sinning, and you're doing all of this dhunub and ma'asi, you're being disobedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and I explained that in my khutbah in Palmdale. I was saying that being a sinner, هذا يخدش في الإيمان. يعمل إيه؟ يخدش الإيمان. يعني إيه يخدش الإيمان؟ الإيمان, إيمانك it will be weak. It is not really strong iman. Your iman will go down, will decrease. But that's why when you ask Allah for His forgiveness, you're telling Allah, Ya Rab, I'm very sorry. I will not trying to do it again. Please wipe out my sin. And if Allah forgives you and He will wipe out your sin, means you are clean, you are pure, you don't have sin, means Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you tawfiq, and He will guide you, and He will give you success to have good Sha'ban and a good Ramadan. Why? Because too many people being deprived from the attendance of Ramadan or Sha'ban or this time, good time for Muslims, Allah multiplying our good deeds. For too many people, they will be deprived from this good time or this good time by doing sin. That's why first of all, we have to clean the house before we receive the guest. You got it? You have a guest is coming to your house. You're telling your wife, I want you to clean the house, perfume, put candles, put light, put مشعرف ايه, fix the couch, clean this and put that and make the food. And you have a يعني special guest. That's why العلماء, they say التخلية قبل التحلية. Got it some more? التخلية قبل التحلية. التخلية means what? To ask Allah for forgiveness, to cleansing yourself, to purify yourself. I want Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to wipe out my sin. I don't need sin anymore. When I gonna have takhliya, then I gonna enjoy later my ibadah. Allah will give me success and tawfiq and guide me to make more ibadat. فالاستغفار, seeking Allah's forgiveness, will purify your heart. يزكي القلب. And it will empower your heart ويقوي القلب. And if you're sick, your heart is sick, Allah عز وجل will cover it up, will give you شفاء, will make your heart strong, empower it. And not just like, الاستغفار, power, شفاء, cure, تزكية, purification, and guidance. And more you ask Allah for His forgiveness, Allah عز وجل will guide your heart. Not just that, that heart will be empty from any kind of doubt, shirk, hypocrisy, all the disease of the hearts, and Allah عز وجل will fill it instead of that with nur, light, guidance, mercy, tranquility, sakina, rahma, all of this because what? You ask Allah for His forgiveness. The main thing or the main key of at-tawbah and receiving these coming days, inshallah, al-istighfar. Allahumma inni astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk. Oh Allah, I am asking for your forgiveness and I am repenting. I'm repenting to you, Ya Rabb al-Alamin. That's why very important to get this meaning. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He said, al-istighfar aman. What is aman? Security. More you ask Allah for His forgiveness, more you will be secured, survived, saved. Who said? Allah Azza wa Jalla. Look what Allah is saying.
وَمَا كَانَ اللَّهُ مُعَذِّبَهُمْ وَأَنْتَ فِيهِمْ وَمَا كَانَ اللَّهُ مُعَذِّبَهُمْ وَهُمْ يَسْتَغْفِرُونَ.
يبقى رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, his attendance with the Sahaba, he was a man for his companions صلى الله عليه وسلم and his community. Why? Because Allah will never, he promised Rasulullah, will never punish them while he was amongst them صلى الله عليه وسلم. طيب رسول الله is not with us anymore. What is the solution? What can we do? He said, وَمَا كَانَ اللَّهُ مُعَذِّبَهُمْ وَمْ يَسْتَغْفِرُونَ. More they asking Allah سبحانه وتعالى for His forgiveness, there is no punishment. يبقى الاستغفار أمان. وكذلك التوبة من الآن. To ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for His forgiveness and al-istighfar from the minor sins. From where? The minor sins. طب what about التوبه, repentance? The scholar, they said التوبه from the major sin. That's why to be smart, when you ask Allah for forgiveness, combine al-istighfar with التوبه. Combine both. Allahumma inni astaghfiruka. Huh? وأتوب إليك. Oh Allah, I am seeking your forgiveness and I am making tawbah too. يبقى الاستغفار from the minor sins and التوبه from the major sins. See? That's why it's aman. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created us and Almighty knows our weakness. That's why when you make one good deed, He multiplied to 10 and 700 and more because you are so weak. If you make a sin and you're sinning and He gave you a chance for 6 hours to ask for forgiveness, what about it? You forgot ba'a, you did not want to ask for forgiveness. The angel will write it in your record, just one sin. Allah. How for a Muslim and a mu'min, one sin can defeat 700 hasana? Never gonna happen. Never gonna happen. If Allah will multiply your, this is one hasan, one good deed. He can make it 10 and He can make it 700. مثل الذين ينفقون أموالهم في سبيل الله كمثل حبة أنبتت سبع سنابل في كل سنبلة 100 حبة والله يضاعف لمن يشاء. 7 by 100 at this. 700. 7 by 100, 700. And if you make this hasana, الله والمطلوب تسيفن عندري or more like الصيام fasting
for example يعني.
That's why الله سبحانه وتعالى said in the Quran
من جاء بالحسنة فله عشر أمثالها ومن جاء بالسيئة فلا يجزى إلا مثلها وهم لا يظلمون.
If you make حسنة الله will multiply it in 10 أمثالها. If you make a sin سيئة gonna be the punishment is just سيئة أو بيسيئة just one that's it and Allah will never wrong anyone. You will never gonna be wronged at all because you, Allah is so just and ولا يظلم ربك أحدا. That's why ربك عز وجل Almighty Allah سبحانه وتعالى my God and your God شرع لنا كسب الحسنات ودلنا على الطرق لفعل الخيرات because of our weakness. Allah عز وجل Almighty He make it شرع for us to make حسنات make good deeds as much as you can and He showed you too many ways to make خيرات good deeds and He make the فرائد فرائد like الحج like الصيام الصلاة الزكاة mandatory this is must He make it for us why to wipe out your sins don't think when you make good deed even if you provide little water like this for a dog thirsty dog Allah will forgive your sin What about if you make the farida and the most beloved thing to Allah is farida. When you make his farida, the mandatory, Allah loves it so much. That's why he said, when you make this faraid, I will wipe out your sins because of that. طيب. What about if you don't have sin? Allah will elevate your rank in Jannah, your status in Jannah. ورفع الدرجات. That's why Hadith said that. الصلوات الخمس. والجمعة إلى الجمعة ورمضان إلى رمضان مكفرات لما بينهن إذا اجتنبت الكبائر from five times صلاة daily in fixed time from صلاة to صلاة Allah will wipe out your sin from Friday to Friday Allah is wiping out your sin جمعة to جمعة from رمضان to رمضان Allah wipe out your sin means when you fast رمضان And you fasted second Ramadan between two Ramadans, خلاص, no sin will be wiped out. What about Salah to Salah? Wiped out. The minor sins, not the major. Major sins and easy tawbah. Okay? All of this, Hadith Nariba Umay Muslim, Hadith Abdullah ibn Amr, Qala sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. For example, here, I give you another way to make good deeds. He said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, 40 khisla. 40 eh? Khisla. أعلاها منيحة العنز ما من عامل يعمل بها بقسطة منها رجاء ثوابها وتصديق موعودها إلا أدخله الله الجنة بها صحيح البخاري Look at this hadith صلى الله عليه وسلم He mentioned 40 good deeds He did not mention these good deeds Any 40 good deeds He said The highest of these good deeds, منيحة العنز. What is منيحة العنز? If you have a little goat, and this little goat has milk, you can milk it. And you give it to your neighbor, your friend, take this goat for 2 days, or 1 day, or whatever, milk it and get drink the milk. This is منيحة العنز. Just to give someone this little goat to milk it and to drink the milk and bring it back to you. When major brother Samir came on, my car was broken and they said, Sheikh, I will give you my car tomorrow to go somewhere. مثلا, use it. That's called منيحة العنز. فالرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم according to the Hadith Bukhari, he said 40 good deeds but he did not tell you what kind of good deeds. Any good deeds. Any good deeds. He said 40. The highest of these good deeds, which is in reward, ajr, If you have a little goat, al-anz, little goat, and you can you give it to your friend, your neighbor, whatever, somebody miskin, to milk it and to use the milk and to return it back to its person. Allahu Akbar. If you do that for the sake of Allah Azza wa Jal, you go to Jannah. Guarantee. Who said that? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Sometimes you are belittling this thing. وَمِنْهَا, for example, الذكر. When you mention the name of Allah and you make ذكر. Bismillah. You make ذكر means you remember Allah. Subhanallah. Alhamdulillah. لا إله إلا الله. استغفر الله. لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. حسبي الله ونعم الوكيل. وأفوض أمري إلى الله. Huh? سبحان الله وبحمده سبحان الله العظيم. Any kind of ذكر. That also will lead you to Jannah. What else? إماطة الأذى عن الطريق. You're walking in the way, you find some broken glass or some banana or branch of tree blocking the way of people. Clean it, take it away. We don't need anybody to be harmed. That's Allah will forgive your sin because of that. There are too many hadith. And there are too many ways. What about if you don't want to make any good deed? What about if you're not able to do these good deeds? The minimum, and Allah will forgive you too, أن تكف شرك عن الناس فإنها صدقة منك على نفسك. To stop doing evil. If you're not doing good, stop doing bad things, evil things, evil deeds. Don't be one of those who are wrongdoers, bad ones, shaitani ones. And this is sadaqah from you to yourself. Because Allah will have mercy on you if you do that. You don't want to make good deeds, but at least stop from doing, freeze yourself from doing bad deeds. Very important. This is sadaqah. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم لا تحقرن من المعروف شيئا ولو أن تلقى أخاك بوجه طلق. Do not belittle any good thing, even if when you see your brothers in the masjid or somewhere, give him a good smile. That's it. Can't you do that? But I don't need plastic smile, because this plastic smile is not count. صح سمور؟ You know the plastic smile? Yeah. It's not count. I need sincere smile. This one. I love this one. So see? So that's why Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم said, at least, if you cannot do something good, if you don't want to do nothing, just when you see someone, give him a good smile. And give him a good hug. Like Haji Samir or Haji Kamal. All the time. I don't know what's wrong. Anyway. Or أن تأكل الأكلة فتحمد الله أو تشرب فتحمد الله. When you eat some food and you say الحمد لله, Allah will forgive your sin. When you drink something, say بسم الله الحمد لله, Allah will forgive your sin. When you say الحمد لله, just you show your gratitude to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. والله عز وجل. The way شرع لنا فعل الحسنات, it's a شرع, it's a part of our deen to make good deeds, because the benefits of these good deeds will go back all the way to you. If you kill yourself from standing all night praying to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala 24/7, you will never gonna benefit Allah. Allah make the sharia, the shar' in Islam, to make good deeds, that because the benefits of these good deeds is going back to you. It's not going back to Allah. The way Allah make it as a sharia, shar' to make good deeds, and he will count this for you, and this is for your own benefit. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said أبواب المحرمات والذنوب. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, do not, the way I ask you to make good deeds, حسنات, do not sin, do not make haram, do not make zinub. Why? Because Allah loves you and he wants your balance to be full of good deeds, not bad deeds. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, قل إنما حرم ربي الفواحش ما ظهر منها وما بطن
والإثم والبغي بغير الحق وأن تشركوا بالله ما لم ينزل به سلطانا وأن تقولوا على الله ما لا تعلمون.
This is Surah Al-A'raf, the chapter of the Heights, verse number 23. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He forbid الفواحش, any shameful acts. Guna, haram, zina, adultery, it's forbidden. ما ظهر منها وما بطن. That one, obviously, people, they are doing it, or the hidden one. والإثم والبغي بغير الحق. Don't sin, don't transgress without any right. وأن تشركوا بالله ما لم ينزل به سلطانا. Do not sit any partner with Allah, which is Allah did not give you authority to do that. Who are you to sit in a partner with Allah سبحانه وتعالى. وأن تقولوا ما لا تعلمون. Don't say something unknowingly without something you don't have any idea about it. That's why صلى الله عليه وسلم said, ما نهيتكم عنه فاجتنبوا. Whatever Rasulullah forbids us from doing it, avoid it completely. Any kind of haram, completely avoid it. And they said, وما أمرتكم به فأتوا منه ما استطعتم. That hadith narrated by Bukhari Muslim. And whatever Rasul صلى الله عليه وسلم asking us to do, as much as you can, do this. As much as you can. ما استطعتم. It's according to your capability. He said, for example, صلي, huh? صلي مثلا for قيام الليل, voluntarily, as much as you can, it's up to you. Any sunan, as much as you can. But the farida, you must do it. Farida, the mandatory, you must do it. Avoid the haram. And brothers and sisters, the main way for your happiness, contentment, in this worldly life and in the hereafter, at-tawbah, repentance. And the tawbah from Allah and the tawbah from you. Repentance from Allah and the repentance from you. How? Siblin ya Mashiach. Siblin ya Allah. Ayo. At-tawbah from Allah, Allah the one who gave us at-tawbah as a sharia, as a shar' manhaj, law, system, part of the system of Allah to make tawbah, to repent to him. And this is out of his mercy, fikra. Imagine if there is no tawbah in this society. Everybody killing, thieves, killers, thieves, riba, corruption, shedding blood, adultery, drinking al-khamr, taking properties of others. See, this is all corruption. People are sinning. Imagine if there is no tawbah. Those who are doing these things, let us increase. ما احنا خربانة خربانة. There is no jannah for us. There is no tawbah. Repentance, let's make more. See? But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when He said there is a tawbah repentance, He's telling the society, stop, stop. The door is still open for you. Stop doing this. Allah will have mercy on you and you're going to enter Jannah. He said, yes, I'm going to do it. Good deal. I'm going to repent. That's why tawbah from Allah, He gave it to you as a shar' part of your deen. What tawbah from al-abd, to ask Allah for forgiveness and to repent, to come back to Him. And if Allah guides you to repent, means He accepted from you. قال ثم تاب عليهم ليتوبوا. If Allah guides you to come to the masjid, means He accepts your salah. If Allah Azzajal guides you to make tawbah, means He accepts it from you. See? And He will be so happy too. Because of it, that's why He asked, he didn't ask, He command. Because the order of Allah must do it. وَتُوبُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا. All of you, make general tawbah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. جَمِيعًا أَيُّهَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ. All believers, the believing women and men. لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ. You might be successful if you do that. See, that's very important. التوبه النصوح. Its conditions, stop الإقلاع عن الذنب. Stop sinning. Number two, الندم, regret. When you remember it, say, I'm sorry, I will never gonna do it. It was so bad time. اتفو على الشيطان. اتفو على my sin. اتفو سمورة. اتفو على الشيطان. Whenever you see الشيطان, اتفو. اديله على طول على طول الشيطان. That's why سبحان الله. Yes. فالندم, regret, and not to do it anymore. عدم العودة أو الرجوع للذنب. If this حقوق العباد, you have to go to the people. Don't backbite, don't slander, don't shed blood, don't take somebody's rights.
because this is also part of the tawbah, condition number 4. فالتوبه النصوح to guard your good deeds and to wipe out your sins and to avoid the punishment of Allah عز وجل. يبقى what is the benefit of التوبه؟ To guard your حسنات. Huh? Number 2, to avoid to be wiped out, your sin will be wiped out. Number 3, you avoid the punishment of Allah عز وجل. There is no عقوبه. طيب الله سبحانه وتعالى سيد سوره طه and قوم يونس, the people of Prophet Jonah, they did that. Allah did not punish them. Surah Taha, Allah said, وَإِنِّي لَغَفَّارٌ لِمَنْ تَابَ وَآمَنَ وَعَمِلَ صَالِحًا وَعَمِلَ صَالِحًا ثُمَّ اهْتَدَى. Indeed, Allah is غفار, فعال. Allah is all forgiven for those who repent. وآمن وعمل صالحا. I just recited in Surah Maryam this ayah in Salat al-Maghrib. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, إلا من تاب وآمن وعمل صالحا فأولئك يدخلون الجنة ولا يظلمون شيء. Accord, this is exactly the same ayah, huh? The three parts together like Surah Maryam here in Surah Taha. Allah said, وإني لغفار, Allah will forgive whom, huh? Those who repent. And they said, وآمن, and believe in the oneness of Allah. طيب, why Allah said, وآمن after توبة? Because your sin تخدش الإيمان. Your sin, more you are sinning, your iman will be down, down, down. You're destroying your iman because of your sin. That's why Allah said, make توبة. And believe means what? Maintain your iman again. Huh? Grow up your iman again. Fix your iman again. And what? How to fix it? Allah said, وَعَمِلَ صَالِحًا by doing righteous good deeds. And after that he said, ثُمَّ اهْتَدَى, he will be guided. That's why might be Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not accept your good deeds or your tawbah because if you're showing off. That's why you have to be sincere. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he asked us for tawbah. He gave us order to do it. And the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he called all mankind. What did he say? He said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Ya ayyuhan nas, O people, tubu ila Allah wa astaghfiru. Repent to Allah and ask for his forgiveness. I am indeed asking Allah for his forgiveness 100 times every day. Rasulullah, he had no sin. Why he asked Allah 100 times forgiveness every day? Just to teach us. Do like him. While the Rasulullah sallam, he been forgiven, there is no sin. But some hadith said, that hadith Muslim said 100 times. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Sayyidina Umar, telling us about that hadith, more you used to sin during Jahiliyyah time, more you can have hasanat when you repent to Allah. Sayyidina Umar, he used to pass by the Sahaba, telling them, I am the one who has the most good deeds amongst you. They said, how do you know, Ya Umar? And they told Rasulullah about that. And the Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, Ya Umar, how do you know you have hasanat, good deeds more than anyone of the community, يعني, the Sahab? He said, Ya Rasulullah, didn't you read Surah Al-Furqan? وَالَّذِينَ لَا يَدْعُونَ مَعَ اللَّهِ إِلَهًا آخَرَ وَلَا يَقْتُلُونَ النَّفْسَ الَّتِي حَرَّمَ اللَّهُ إِلَّا بِالْحَقِّ وَلَا يَزْنُونَ وَمَنْ يَفْعَلْ ذَلِكَ يَلْقَ أَثَامًا يُضَاعَفْ لَهُ الْعَذَابُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ وَيَخْلُدْ فِيهِ مُهَانًا إِلَّا مَنْ تَابَ وَآمَنَ وَعَمِلَ عَمَلًا صَالِحًا فَأُولَٰئِكَ يُبَدِّلُ اللَّهُ سَيِّئَاتِهِمْ حَسَنَاتٍ. I had the most amongst them during Jahiliyyah time bad deeds, Ya Rasulullah. I used to make bad deeds more than anyone of them. Allah Azza Jal, because of my iman, I became Muslim. Allah replaced it all to the good deeds according to this verse. Except to those who repent and believe in the oneness of Allah, they maintain their iman. وَعَمِلَ صَالِحًا, they make عَمَلًا صَالِحًا, they make righteous good deeds after that. فَأُولَٰئِكَ, those Allah Azza wa Jal exchange their sin to hasanat, to good deeds. But that's why, Rasulullah, I have the most hasanat amongst them. We have to know that Allah Kareem, all generous. Allah Rahim, all merciful. Allah Halim, he is forbearing, forgiving people. Abu Musa al-Ash'ari said, Hadith Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, إن الله يبسط يده بالليل ليتوب مسيء النهار. Allah is opening, extending his hand
during the night time for those they used to sin during the daytime to ask for forgiveness. The sinners of the day, Allah at night is opening his hand for you. وَيَبْسُطْ يَدَهُ بِالنَّهَارِ لِيَتُوبَ مُسِيءُ اللَّيْلِ. And he extending his hand, Almighty Azza wa Jal, during the day for those who used to sin during the night. I'm still opening my hand to you. Come to me. Come to me. Where are you going? فَأَيْنَ تَذْهَبُونَ. Hadith Sahih Muslim. فَأَمَّا مَنْ تَابَ وَآمَنَ وَعَمِلَ صَالِحًا. Surah Al-Qasas, verse 67. فَأَمَّا, indeed, for those who repent, تَابَ وَآمَنَ, again, see, تَوْبَ إِمَانَ عَمَلْ صَالِحًا. Three together. Do you remember the doctors nowadays, what they call mutalazima? What's mutalazima? If you have cholesterol, you have diabetic, you are diabetic, and you have, what is the third one? Cholesterol, وسكري, والضغط, pressure, high blood pressure. High blood pressure, with diabetic, with cholesterol. Three, they are cousins. If you have one, you have another ones. That's why in the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Tawbah, iman, amal salih. All the time they come together. Tawbah, because your tawbah against your iman. Your sin against your iman. More you're sinning, your iman will be down, 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 down. But if you repent, your iman gonna go up? La. Allah said, you have to believe, you have to maintain your iman again. طيب, how to maintain your iman? Your iman is going up. وعمل صالحة, to make righteous good deeds. See? Through the righteous good deeds, your iman will be up again. Because al-ma'asi takhdishul iman. The ma'asi, more you're sinning, this is against your iman. That's why he said, taba wa amana wa amila. Ma'a ba'd. Huh? They are mutalazma together. كده. Remember, high blood pressure, cholesterol, and diabetes. Three together. They are together. Tawba, iman, amal salih. One of them cannot go away from the two. For that's why, فَأَمَّا مَنْ تَابَ وَآمَنَ وَعَمِلَ صَالِحًا فَعَسَىٰ أَنْ يَكُونَ مِنَ الْمُفْلِحِينَ. If you repent with belief, you maintain your faith, your iman, by making righteous good deeds according to this ayah, فَعَسَىٰ, عَسَىٰ is a hope, might be, it's a hope, عَسَىٰ لَعَلَّ, this in Arabic, for hope. Allah said, these people, they will be successful. Might be, they will be successful. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be happy if you repent to him subhanahu wa ta'ala. يبقى now to receive these good days that are coming, Rajab, Sha'ban, Ramadan, first of all with the tawbah. Why tawbah? Because if you have sin, might be Allah will not give you tawfiq to make good Ramadan and good Sha'ban. But if you ask Allah for forgiveness and tawbah, Ya Rabbi, no sin, please. At-takhliyah qabla at-tahliyah. Like what the ulama said. If you have a guest, ask your wife to clean the house, to fix it, the couch, perfume it, candles, kaza, mashallah, beautiful. And then make good food and fill the table. Our guest is coming, special guest. This is what you have to do. At-takhliyah qabla at-tahliyah. Cleansing yourself, no sin, tawbah. And then receive Ramadan and enjoy Ramadan with no bad deeds. That's why hikmat Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why Allah forgives Muslims in the night of 15th of Sha'ban. Look, when I remember this, I said, Allahu Akbar, Alhamdulillah, Ya Rabbi, or my God. You're not going Ramadan to be forgiven. Already you've been forgiven, Ya Habibi, before Ramadan. 2 weeks before Ramadan, you've been forgiven. In the night of 15th of Sha'ban, if you are not mushrik, and if you don't have any hatred against the Muslims, Allah Azza wa Jal will forgive you in that night, 15th of Sha'ban. طيب, what about Ramadan? Ya Ammi, التخليه. I'm cleaning myself before Ramadan. Ramadan, this is the sweet, the halawa. I'm going to enjoy Ramadan, the hasanat. No forgiveness. Don't ask for forgiveness in Ramadan. Ask for hasanat, jannat al-firdaws al-a'la. Forgiveness, 15th of the night of Sha'ban. Khalas, that's it, you will be forgiven. If you are not mushrik, you're not worshipping others to Allah, and you don't have any hatred against anyone. Talk to the people, that's it. Be forgiven Ramadan, just enjoy it. Khalas, hasanat more, inshallah. جزاكم الله خير. مسك الله ان تقبل منا واياكم صالح اعمال ان شاء الله. It's coming Tuesday between Maghrib and Isha from 6 to 7. We're gonna celebrate the الاسراء والمعراج. Gonna be the night of 27th, which is 26th of Rajab ان شاء الله. And it will be 6th of February. We're gonna have Sheikh Tariq عبد الرحمن from Long Beach, Sheikh Ali Shams الدين قارئ from 6 to 7. Let everybody know ان شاء الله. Might be somebody gonna give some sambusak and some halwa and